Okay, and now we are in the last verse of this surah. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. Nice. But I think it's very long verse for you. And many people don't recite Surah Al-Fatiha like this. Rather, they split this verse into two pieces, right? So I will do it also. Okay, let's try. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. Great. So we find here صاد and طاء as in the previous verse. And then Allah says, غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. Okay, here we find a new letter like غين. So remember that غين is the brother of خاء, and many of you, I'm sure that you can pronounce kha in the proper way, so indeed you are able also to pronounce ghain if you know that it is the brother of the kha. So just pronounce ghain at the same point of articulation with kha. Kha. So gha, gha, ag, ach, ag. Okay, great. So here we say غَيْرِل, غَيْرِل, غَ, and don't forget that غَيْن is the thick letter, so you open your mouth ovally in the oval pattern like this, and don't round your lip like O, غَيْرِل, no, it is fathah, not O, غَيْرِل, yeah. It's near from the O sound, but it's not exactly the O sound. It's fatha. Ghayril. Magh and magh here. Yeah, you see that the sound of ghayn isn't the sound of qalqala. And ghayn, it is not the letter of qalqala. Ghayn. So you don't say magh. Rather, it is maghdu, not maghdu. So, just let it flow, this lengthened voice. Maghdu, maghdu. In order to not make the qalqalah voice. And then, the next new letter is dad, dad, and dad. As you know, we use the both side, it's better. You may also use the right side only, or just the left side or of your tongue. Of your tongue. Here. Yeah? But I prefer to use both of them. Or both of the sides of the tongue. And then you push this side, the right side, to the right side of your teeth, the below teeth, right? Like this. And then also do the same thing with the left side of the tongue, with the left side of below teeth, and then like this, so it is the elastic tongue, you know. Okay, push the both sides, and then do. So don't push your fronter or your front side of the tongue. Don't use it. Instead, use your sides of tongue. This is the makhraj, the point of articulation of the letter of dad. Bu, bu, bu. Yeah, you. How to say? You touch your upper mouth or upper teeth here. Yeah, just touch it a bit. Do, do, do. So like this. You push the sides of your teeth and then move to the front and touch your upper teeth just a bit. Do, 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 do. But push your left and right sides of your tongue. This is the main makhraj of dad. And just touch a bit the front of your tongue to the upper of your to your upper teeth. Again, do, do. Just listen to me carefully, and then you follow me. And every time you may forget how to say dot again. You see this video. And then listen again and try to follow me and do like that. Do, do, do. Okay. Great. Maghdubi alayhim walaw. Also, dod. And then you have here the very long mat. Very long voice of mat. We say it the mat. Lazim, mad lazim kalimi, but you may forget the name of this mad, but don't forget you must pronounce it longly in the six harokat. Okay, but don't forget to do nabr at the end of this mad. So this is the second circumstance that you make number voice. The first one in the previous verse, Iyaka, in the fifth verse of this surah. And this is the second circumstance whenever you find mat lazim kalim like this. Dol. So at the end of the mat, before the next letter, just raise your voice louder. Bolin and press it. So this accent, this number, to raise your voice and to press it. This is how you pronounce the letter of lam or maybe sod or something like that after this mat in the proper way, clearly, obviously. Unless you do this, you may pronounce lam without the shadda, waladdallin, without shadda. So this is the wrong way. And exceptions is just for the noon and mim. If the letter after this very long mat is the noon or the mim, so you don't make number at that circumstance. Like Alif Lam Mim without naba. Lam Mim. Lam, not Lam. It is wrong. And noon like Dhonina Billahi Dhonna Sawin Surah Al-Fatih. Okay. That's all for this lesson, and after that you say Amin in the end of Al-Fatiha, because Al-Fatiha consists with du'a. There is du'a in the middle of the Al-Fatiha, Ihdinash Shiratal Mustaqim, so we say Amin. That's all for today, and see you in the next video, next lesson. May Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala protect you always. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.